You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino.
The Sierra Madre Casino? You need to break inside.
The gala's tied to the casino draws on its power. Might cause it to reset itself, open the doors for a bit like it was supposed to.
Finally! Now, the gates will open.
Welcome to the Sierra Madre in all its glory. Woke it up good. Head to the lobby and we'll deal with you, friends.
He said the Brotherhood was doomed, but that he'd return, save us, make the Mojave like it was meant to be. Wipe the slate clean.
Hello, Internet, and welcome back to another adventure of Mr. Jammy B'Stard, the luckiest son of a bitch who's ever walked the Mojave Wasteland. Okay, in this episode, let's just get this finished. We're quite near the end of Dead Money, and this is where we are just gonna end everything. We're gonna finally finish this bloody DLC. Oh god, I just want it to end. I'm sick of ghost people. I'm sick of traps every 5 feet. I'm sick and tired of fucking poison cloud. But although now I am inside Sierra Madre, we no longer have to worry about the poison cloud, but... And then after that, we can actually play a DLC that I actually like. Okay, let's see here. Let's switch to the police pistol.
Going to make casino burn. No more being.
Dog?
Check the main casino side corridors.
Please let me help us. If you don't, then you're
going to make casino burn. No more being.
Okay, now we've got to go through the casino. If I remember correctly, straight up here. Up here. Doors hermetically sealed due to a gas leak. If you override the door's lock, you won't be able to open it from the other side until you shut off the gas valves and dealt with Dog. Okay. Let's save. Okay.
That idiot's opened the gas valves. A single spark, or he sets off his collar. The casino's going to burn. Us, along with him. Shut off the gas valves or that idiot'll kill us all.
To protect you, always. All of you? Master. No, not Master. Dog remembers you. Left Dog in cage. Mean to Dog. Now Dog.
Will kill us both unless you do something. Never felt him so strong before. He won't listen to my voice. He's
hungry. Come here or Dog will chase you.
break you until you no run anymore.
Dog, stay. If you don't, Master will be mad.
Master? Don't want Master to be mad. What does Master want Dog to...
Listen to you. Can't hold him back much longer. Tell him to pull on his chain as hard as...
Dog can. What Master wants, Dog can do. Please don't be mad with Dog.
Dog, the Master sent me. He commands you to listen to my voice now.
Master? Master? Dog? Dog is listening.
Both of us are. Tell him to listen to me. Then we can get out of this. Finally. And...
Now Dog is listening to voice. Your voice only.
Right, this puts me in a bit of an odd position because in all of my playthroughs, I've never seen this this dialogue tree before, because I have a feeling because we haven't actually sat down and properly talked with Dog. Imagine the voice not as a voice, but as... Imagine the voice not as a voice, but as water. Look at the voice now. What do you see?
Dog can see the voice. Looks just like Dog.
And Dog looks just like me. You've hurt yourself. Inside. Do you see now? See?
In the water. Dog understands now. Dog knows what happened.
Then step into the water. Step into yourself.
If Dog goes into the water, Dog can't help if Master gets mad. You were nice to Dog. Dog wants to help.
He's right. If you merge us, then we, or whatever we become, we can't help you when you reach whatever's at the Sierra Madre's end.
And Dog... Dog doesn't want to unremember you, may forget you.
We will forget almost all that has happened here. You'll be alone, at the old man's mercy. Like Dog. Like me.
Aha! Never mind, it actually... I guess that the option I chose does go to the specific outcome I always do. It's just that it was worded in a different way. Right, so there are two ways you can do this. You can either command Dog to kill himself, or flippin' ask God to take over, or you can merge their personalities together. But the thing is, it's like a complete reboot of a computer after a system recovery. He can't remember who you are or where he is. Okay. Not having your help doesn't matter if this heals you.
Dog understands. Dog has done bad things. Knows why voice was
furious with him. Tired of the anger. Thank you, Courier. Even if it's only for minutes before the Sierra Madre kills us all, then...
Dog hopes you find a way to save Self, like you helped Dog, and...
When you meet him, find a way to save yourself, as you tried to save us. Otherwise, I'll be upset with you.
We came this far, I'll manage. Go on. Let go.
You were there all the time.
All the time. You were there. And so close. Together.
Dog? Hello? You there, Dog?
Who are you? What is this place?
We're trapped inside a casino in a poisonous city.
That was not the answer I was expecting. I don't know you, yet I feel like I do, and a feeling of gratitude. Forgive me, I'm wounded. This chain, this bear trap on my arm. How did I even get this far with these wounds? The pain is excruciating. I need to rest for a moment.
If you get the strength to leave, do so quickly.
Thank you for whatever you have done. I will remain here. Need to get my strength back.
And that's dog taken care of. And we've leveled up. Yes, okay. Barter.
Hang on.
Oh no, because I can't choose that perk yet. Energy weapons. Put a point into them. Repair up to 80. Let's put a point into unarmored. And let's get survival up to 70. That's it. The gas valves have all been repaired. Emergency door has been unlocked. Ooh, lad's life, I'll have that. Eight of clubs. Of course, now that we've got that lesson learned perk where we add plus whatever percent. Yeah, we get extra experience based on our level. We now properly not only negate the skilled trait, but we also manage to get some extra experience on top of that. Okay. We've got three lunch boxes. Need some pork and beans. Where's the pork and beans? Aha! Mr. Mash. Three caravan lunches. Okay, so we can't go through there. Dog is just going to do what happened there. Bit of a frame rate went through a bit of a wobble. Okay. What have we got? Switch to the holo rifle. There's going to be a lot of flipping. Because the ghost people are going to be in the casino now. And that's dog taken care of. Now, we're going to go to the Tropico Theater.
You've got one of the floors reestablished. Good. Accessing the music archives now. Two more to go. Oh, it seems the casino has uninvited guests. The villa inhabitants were pounding at the doors. Now they found a way inside. Deal with them, and don't try and leave yourself, or I'll let the caller do its work.
Had enough ghost people. Fucking die! Shit, there's more of them. Shit, one's got a gas bomb. Bastard. Eat it! What the hell did he pause for? What were you pausing there for, Jammy? Building suspense?
Let's have six of those. Caravan lunch. We go now where we go. Again, dropping frame rate. Okay, the Tampico Theater. I'm coming for you, Dean.
If that ghoul's still alive, correct that. I'll break him.
Password. Urgent message for Mrs. E. Sands. Security code. Okay. Dean Domino. Vera's Potichers. Key. Dean.
Finally, a friendly face. Hey, partner. Up here. They're in a bit of a predicament here. Had to duck backstage, take a powder. The audience is a little murderous tonight.
How did you get here from the gala event?
I was already halfway off the rooftop, through the service tunnel and making a break for the gate before the light show started, and before Vera finished her gala speech. I knew what had happened with music in the streets and lights in the sky. Ghost people. Lots of them. Also meant the front gate was open. And no way was I missing it after all these years. Then, I walk in, and...
casino security hit you like it hit me when you reached the lobby?
No idea. Woke up here, thought I was dreaming for a second. Right back on the stage, the mic. Thought I was back at the Fronds. Well, except no audience used to pack theatres back then. So, stepped up on the stage, checked things out. Then suddenly, holograms walked out of the wings. They started raising their hands to their heads, all creepy-like. Not a good sign.
I didn't see any security coming in, only the speakers.
Look, those ghosts are going to come out of the wings behind you in a second. The security types, not the friendly, bald types. And if you got in here, the door's probably locked tight behind you, so don't back up or run for the exit. You're not going to make it. Trust me, as soon as you can, run to the door to the left. Use the key you got out of the music rag there and camp out. As bad as things are, it's going to get a lot worse if either of us pops. So get backstage until we get a better plan.
Wait, I need to head to the door to your left or my left?
What? Oh, my left. Your right. So, yeah, run to the door on your right. Almost got you killed there. Us killed there.
I need a little more than that to go on if we're going to break out of here.
Right. Let's see. When you get the door open, there'll be an exit door dead ahead. Don't take it. It's most likely filled with toxins from the vents, so hug the wall. Make as much space between you and the door, or it's Cloud Nine in a casket. Past that is my dressing room. Under the table there's a footlocker. It's tucked back a bit, so you might miss it. Inside, a gun, some ammo. Not much help against the ghosts. Still, if you're about to give up, call it quits. Throw it to me, so I can eat a bullet first.
Dean, the theatre speakers are wired to a central sound system, right?
Yeah. Yeah, so what? We got bigger problems with the holograms. No, wait. You're right. The theatre piped music and sound backstage, which means those little squealers are in the corridors back there, too.
One problem at a time. Take a breath. Try and remember.
Let's see. Once you break right, watch each turn in the corridor. One will be on your right, past my dressing room, and up. My dressing room. May have left the radio on, right by the table. If you could just shut it off instead of blowing it out. Never mind. And there was a speaker in the prop room, too, on the wall between the entrances. And, well, walk slow. There's bound to be more.
That's the radios and speakers. What about a central sound system?
The speakers are all controlled by a central console. It's the farthest from the only door out of here, so you'd need to do a full circuit of the corridor to get to it. Once there, you'll need to shut it down, and I don't have the code. If you have the code, you can turn off all the speakers. Make them settle down. Getting backstage should buy us time. Just take it slow.
Getting backstage is a temporary measure if I can't find a security terminal.
Yeah, right. So, let's see. Security's here because the show hasn't started. Guests aren't allowed in, so guess we need to start the show. Okay, so when they were setting this place up, we had rehearsals, and Sinclair even set up hologram recordings of the shows so we could watch and critique our performances before a fake audience. Whatever. Thing is, when the recording queued up, a nice, calm, appreciative audience appeared in the theatre. No security with their head blasting zap rays. So, find the music, get it to the projector room upstairs, then play it. Might reset security with a shot.
All right, makes sense. Where's the music?
The holotape should be where I left it. No, wait. It's in Vera's dressing room, probably. Maybe a key to her room on my desk. Anyway, snag the key out of my room and look around Vera's room. The holotape has to be there. As for getting it to the projection booth, well, sometimes Vera used to watch from the projection booth, so she must have had a master key. Look around her room. Might be there.
Yeah, what are you doing with the key to her room?
Do I have to spell it out? Come on. Time's wasting, and those holograms are going to be on us any second.
This casino security system is pissing me off.
You are preaching to the choir. Sinclair and his security, don't even get me started. Those holograms, look, just get rid of them, all right? Tried to slip off stage, then they all started changing color and raising their hands. Not a good sign.
Let's go. Save.
Maybe I can shut down these ghosts using the stage manager's old German. Damn it! Well, so much for that idea.
Yep, family. Shot the child, shot the wife, shot himself. Okay, so another speaker around here. Sell meeting people. The master key. Okay. So what happened yesterday?
going to rat me out for what happened to the villa. I'm not the one who laid the foundation. I'm not going to take the fall for the support either. They try and pin this on me, I'll let them all know what's really going on with the construction contract. Okay.
Pretty as a picture.
Just run.
Those electric ghosts aren't the kind of audience I like at the best of times. At least the ones in the villa had manners. Don't even know how I ended up here. Guess the casino still recognizes guests, even after all this time, huh? How's that for history?
Are you all right?
Yeah, now. Talk about a captive audience. Or captive entertainer? Whatever. Look, I'm more about the short goodbyes than long thankful speeches. But I appreciate you bailing me out of a tight spot there, partner. I know you didn't do it out of the goodness of your heart. So let me give you something a little more practical. A way we both come out ahead.
I'm listening.
I'm not an idiot. I know the reason I'm in here now is because of the old guy. And you. And you're wearing a collar, so I trust you a little more than the old guy. He's more controlling than I'd like. Thing is, here's where being my partner pays off. See, I know how to get into the casino vault.
What do you mean?
There's a private elevator, Sinclair's elevator. It's up in the executive suites in Vera's room. Not a coincidence. Vera. She was my other partner before the bomb. Took some legwork. Some convincing made it happen.
How so?
Sinclair was already puppy-eyed, so all I had to do was the introductions. She smiled, fluttered her eyes, showed a little leg. And he built this whole place for her. Made her the key to his vault, like a joke, 'cause of her name. Her fake Hollywood name. Except Sinclair didn't know I'd been there first. I could twist her whatever direction I wanted.
Go on.
All she had to do was get inside the Sierra Madre for the gala, then use her voice to open the door. After that, smooth sailing would have been the biggest heist in history. Sinclair left holding the bag. Ruined.
So what happened?
The bomb. Vera got sealed in here. A few hundred years go by, give or take. Almost the end of the story. Then you came along. Now we finish the job. Rob the Sierra Madre, rip out its heart. Last chapter of Frederick Sinclair. Close the book.
What was the problem with Sinclair?
Problem? All high and mighty. lording it over everyone, acting so self-righteous, like nothing could touch him. He was the one with the problem. Never got mad at anything, nothing seemed to shake him. Even after his life kept getting dragged through the dirt. Always kept looking for the bright, shining future in everything. So, I decided to take everything from him.
But what did he do to you?
Do to me? What, weren't you listening? He thought he was better than me. Don't believe me? Look around. This big casino. This big, colossal monument. Think it was for some woman? No. All ego. All self-righteous and lights. Fit him perfect. Had to take him down a few pegs. Bring him down to my level. Begin again? Some things you don't get up from. I was going to prove it.
Forget Sinclair. If Vera was the key, she's dead.
I only saw her yesterday. Well, a few yesterdays. The one who makes all the hand signs, a little tight around the corners of her mouth. I put her in the clinic, tuned her like an instrument. If she heals up, it's not going to be her voice speaking anymore.
Christine!
That is, if the Sierra Madre didn't get her. If it did, well, there's enough of Vera around for me to spend a few years piecing a book together.
And if she is alive?
Then she can make some beautiful music. I'm not banking on it. So here's the short of it. Piece together Little Miss Vera Key's song in the right order. Sierra Madre, opens its legs, we're in business.
So it's a voice password. The key is an electronic.
Go, knock yourself out. I'm just going to catch my breath a bit. That performance, well, more pressure than I was expecting.
Ace of clubs. You know what? I think I might play a few rounds of Caravan in the future, or future episodes, just to see what these Sierra Madre cards look like.
Thread the archives together at the main floor terminal.
Eat it. Stuck on the scenery. Right. That's Doug, Dean, and now Christine.
Security's activated, and emitter signals are lighting up all over this floor. I'll do what I can from here. Floor's got holographic security. Not latest tech. Field of view targeting systems. Primitive. Familiar.
Why did you leave me here? Why? Sinclair! Sinclair! I'm going to die here. Amongst the ghosts.
Sounds like Cortana from Halo.
Security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here. I'm going to die here.
Oh, shit.
Ghosts. I'm still being recorded by the holographic system. James. It's so hard to be here. No. No, I just want to leave. Please.
The emitter has to be somewhere.
Hear the other guests screaming to be let out, to let go. I'm still being.
Executive suites are such a bloody labyrinth. What a stroke of luck. Disable the hallway. No speakers. Program code snippet. Superheated knife. Speakers offline. Okay. Now, if I remember correctly. It's a door. Ah, Madre's lobby. He needs Labby. That X is right. Doors are magically sealed.
what we've done. I'm so sorry, Sinclair. Sorry, I should have trusted you.
There it is. Right. I should be one hologram dealt with. Yeah. Take those. Okay. No, I've been through here. Okay. So. That elevator. Go through here. Go down here. Now we can't go through there. So go through here.
Sinclair? Sinclair, I'm trapped.
No, we've just gone round in a circle. Alright, what's through here? Yeah, just gone round in a circle. Well, there were two terminals. Ah, there we go. We just override.
Sinclair,
there we are.
God, the security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here. Security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here. I'm so sorry to die here. Amongst the ghosts. I'm still being recorded by the holographic system. I can hear the other guests screaming to be let out. To let go. Sinclair, I just want to leave. Sinclair, where did you go? Why did you leave me here? Why? Sinclair? Sinclair, I'm trapped. Please. Oh, God, the security systems won't let me...
What's that on the table? Security password note. Ah, security. Mostly reviewed all of that. What tells us chivalry? Those. Okay, well, sounds like assigned. Yes! Unlock security closet. Recalibrate hologram IFF. Good. Yes! We don't have to worry about the, Oh, there's a hunting shotgun here, but I'm not going to take that. Drop in frame rate again.
I can hear the other guests screaming to be let out, to let go. Let go. Let go of what? It came so far to be here. Now, now I just want to leave. Please, let me leave. Sinclair? Sinclair, where did you go?
Ah, here we are. The penthouse suite.
Sinclair? Sinclair, I'm trapped. Please. God, security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here. Sinclair! Sinclair!
Feels like a sore throat after chewing on nails.
That's Christine. Okay. What is my science skill? 85. Big book of science. Today's physician.
You made it. Good. First to talk. I'll keep this quick in case my voice goes out.
You sound like the woman in the Sierra Madre broadcast.
Do I? It sounds off to my ears. Hard to tell. Not to mention it hurts like hell to swallow. Might be why I got moved off to this suite. It's hers. That's her over there. Got trapped by security like I did. Just took a different way out.
Now that you got your voice back, what did you want to say?
I've been hunting the one who hijacked your Pip-Boy, Elijah, for some time. He cannot leave the Sierra Madre alive. What he's done here is nothing compared to what he's done in the past. The only way to bring him out is if you get to the vault. He won't allow you to go down there alone. That's when we kill him.
How long have you been hunting him?
Too long. Thought I might have had a chance to settle it before this event happened. But then the chance slipped away again.
Settle it. You're here to kill him?
Those are my orders. I've seen what he's done, and I believe in those orders.
Ah, so she's with the Brotherhood of Steel. Sounds personal.
He cut me off from someone I cared about a long time ago. He used his status to break us apart. So I had to find a new purpose. Same banner. Then he became unstable. Left a trail of crimes across the wasteland. Once word reached us, I was ordered to kill him.
He said he knew you.
He saw me before the scars at a place far from here. It's where he found some of the technology he uses now. It's a place called the Big Empty. The name's deceptive if you know where to look. Almost got trapped there. There was someone else, though, who came along. Knew about Elijah.
And that's foreshadowing for the Old World Blues DLC. Okay, he knew Elijah? How?
No idea. A courier. Wore an Old World flag on his back. He was the one who pulled me out there. Told me where Elijah had gone. Helped me heal up. Listened to my story. He sympathized.
And that's foreshadowing for the Lonesome Road DLC. Sympathized? Why?
He said he understood what it meant to track someone who had such a impact on his past life. He said people were like couriers, sometimes never understanding the messages they brought. That's who he was hunting for. Some courier.
More foreshadowing for the Lonesome Road DLC. You could have said something sooner.
Wasn't sure until now I could trust you. Now I know. Look, when I woke up here, however that happened, I had this key on me. I think it belongs to her. Haven't had a chance to use it yet. Might open the dresser or the safe. Didn't have time to experiment with it before you arrived. Here you go.
How did you get here from the gala event and onto this floor?
The gala went off. The switching station opened up. Thought the screeching in the auto dock was bad. Station worse. Got outside, saw the light show, and it was enough to make me run to the casino. Also, it seemed like the lights and speakers were helping to guide me. Guess your master wanted a backup in case you died. As for being assigned to this floor, maybe it's because of my new voice. Your guess is as good as mine. Maybe it recognized me as a guest.
There's a chance he'll see reason.
Try and reason with him. See what happens. He's so lost in his technology. I don't think he even understands why anymore. Wasn't sure.
Does the auto dock there work?
Yeah, still functional. A lot of garbage data on it. Its basic procedures should still work fine.
Anything you can download of it?
I can see. Check the route. Recent diagnostics. A lot of Med-X was dispensed for Vera Keys. Guess that's her corpse there for certain. And why all those meds are scattered around in here. Here's the medical report. Looks like she had some sort of terminal condition. Diagnosis isn't conclusive. Must have been painful. I'm not even sure she knew if these medical reports are enough. She must have been numb most of the time.
Just glad you're safe. Hold up here, I'll take care of Elijah.
Good luck. He's not an easy opponent. If I can, I'll help. Might be able to figure something out using the Sierra Madre's computer systems.
I leveled up again! Barter up to 65. Actually, we're going to bring Barter all the way up to 70, because then we can get the Pack Rat perk. I hope. Pack Rat. You have learned the value of careful packing. Items with a weight of 2 or less weigh half as much for you. Yes, because that means we can carry more stuff. Have a dress for Veronica. Dead man's hand complete. Okay, let's get back down to the lobby. Force metal helmet. Right, now, need to get back to the lobby. It's Labby! Pet valve. Take all of that.